My name is Cheryl. I'm a medical marijuana patient in California, and I suffer from thoracic outlet syndrome. I suffer through chronic pain in my upper body, from my back to my shoulders, through my arms, in my neck, and my head. I've been prescribed over 100 different kinds of prescription drugs. Right now, I only use them as I need them, as my pain gets out of control, and I generally only take half dosage. Medical marijuana doesn't give me the same reaction and allows me to function through my day. It's important to have safe access to my medicine. Before I became a legal California patient, medical marijuana patient, I would often be in uncomfortable situations, not the cleanliest situations, and just sometimes all around not safe to be going into certain neighborhoods or certain individuals' places of residency to pick up medicine. So now that I'm a patient, I'm able to find a dispensary with a clean, safe environment where people are knowledgeable about the strains and the products that they're able to supply. I became an activist shortly after becoming a patient when I saw that federal policy was still impacting individuals and communities in California. From there, I joined ASA. I paid, I think, like a $35 membership fee for a year and started getting their activism alerts. One day, I got a notice that there was a raid going on at a dispensary. So I went down to the location to see if I could help out in any way. And the DEA had already been in and out, raided the place, took all the money. From that point forward, I decided I wanted to do everything I could so that individuals wouldn't get prosecuted or raided. The way I got involved with the Charlie Lynch trial was I was at an Americans for Safe Access meeting that was about knowing your rights. And at that meeting, they had announced that the Charlie Lynch trial was coming up. I got really involved by just researching the situation. I got a hold of local and national media, and from there just tried to spread the word. There's a lot of misinformation out about cannabis, and it's very important to get people educated, outreach to police department, law enforcement, government officials, so that they're aware of the facts and not the stereotypes and not the misinformation. I'm Cheryl, I'm an activist. Take action now and go to ajnog.com to find out how.